led by 12 at one point, but Tech rallies to get within a possession as we start the second half here in Lubbock. And welcome back to West Texas. Mitch Holters with you along with Reed Geddes. Now, West Virginia got some separation, but Tech just gutted it out, and they went to Ty Nurse to get 7 points.
Well, exactly what we expected as far as how the game played out. It's going to come down to turnovers. Both teams had 12. It's going to come down to free throw attempts. Texas Tech won. What we didn't expect was a Ty Nurse sighting. He was very good off the bench, provided some big shots, a good momentum going into the locker room by Ty Nurse.
Ty Nurse of last year.
Now, I really felt like the best player on the court in the first half of the basketball game was Dennis Caligula. He only had 5 points, had three nice blocks in transition, was a difference maker. Jay Crockett, as he has done all year long, came off the bench for Texas Tech and really made a difference. Got in foul trouble. Texas Tech able to stay close with Jay Crockett on the bench in foul trouble.
Now let's take a look at our Papa John's first half stats. Turnovers were an issue both ways. 24 combined turnovers in the first 20 minutes. Free throws. Tech, though, 9 of 11, kept them in the game. West Virginia hit 6 threes. They are next to last in the conference in shooting threes. And so to get 6 threes in a game is huge for the Mountaineers. They got 3 from Terry Henderson, 2 from Gary Brown. And 1 from Kevin Noreen. Now, Bob Huggins trying to get something manufactured here to start the half.
Let's see if they do better on their baseline out-of-bounds plays than they did in the first half. Boy, if I'm West Virginia, I would get that ball to Dennis Caligula a couple of times real quick here in the second half and see what happens.
Harris, a deep three, the 7th three of the game for the Mountaineers.
We talked about it in the first half. If Texas Tech's going to go underneath those screens up top, it is going to open up that shot at the top of the key. West Virginia knocks a couple of those down, different ball game.
Tolbert athletic.
Ooh, he landed on his tailbone. That Chris Walker was trying to deliver to Dejan Kravich, but if it was play hard and play with more energy, boy, the message has been received from Coach Walker and incorporated out here on the floor, because he has played extremely hard going after loose balls, contesting, being a factor down on the offensive glass. Now there's that chunk again, and I don't know why guys hold their hands up like, why are you calling this? They will call it every single time that a cutter cuts through the middle and you bump it. You're just not allowed to do that. And that's a good call. They've called it all year long, and you've got to adjust the way you play. Beat him to a spot, but you're not going to stop a cutter by bumping it.
Kravich blocking the three by Harris. But West Virginia keeping possession, and Harris slicing to the basket. Aaron Harris with 8. He had 19 against TCU and 17 at Oklahoma State, and now a foul on West Virginia.
Aaron Harris has been very good in this game, and a nice job of taking a pass and not settling for a jump shot, but attacking the glass. It's a good-looking kid. 6'2", but, you know, he looks longer than that. He's got long arms, and if you didn't know, you didn't have a roster, you'd think this kid was 6'5", with how long he is.
And both these teams looking for bricks to build with. Josh Gray provides that for Texas Tech, but Aaron Harris does it for Huggs and West Virginia.
Well, they are trying to get Ty Nurse a shot.
And they got it. Ty Nurse. This is the Ty Nurse of last year. People need to realize he hasn't done this all year. His season high was 5 before today.
Oh, that was great execution. That was an elevator door coming on the weak side. Had two high guys upside, and like an elevator door, they let Ty Nurse through the middle, and then they pinch shut.
Caligula gets the bucket, and he's fouled.
Boy, that was strong by Dennis Caligula. Watch this off arm. He settled for a fadeaway jump hook last time. This time, attacking the basket. May have gotten away with an offensive foul. Had that right arm out, holding off Kravic.
And Kalitzla, who was one of two, and that's right at his average. Trying to get the three-point play here for the Mountaineers. And he gets the roll. I had Ty Nurse earlier this year. Just lost his, totally lost his confidence for Tech. He's got it back today. It's like he's having fun playing today. On the dribbler. Hines is called for his third foul. Jabari Hines, three fouls and no points. I had him in an all-star game at the Final Four a couple years ago in Houston. Coming out of Mount Vernon, New York, which is a area that produced tons of players. And he's had his moments now. He had 20 at Iowa State in a rally.
He's the leading scorer for West Virginia in conference games. Averaging 11 points per game and still has not scored. But Kravic keeps jumping when he passes, and I don't know why he does that, but he's going to have a turnover here in a second. You don't want anybody jumping to pass, but you sure don't want your big guy doing it.
Well, he got a pass here. He jumps to score, and he's got an and-one opportunity. Oh, they're going to call this offensive.
Yeah, they did. The question is, did the defensive player move forward up into him? Watch as it's coming into your living room. Well, that's a pretty good call.
Pretty good call.
That's
yeah.
A pretty good call. Sure is. I thought that the defensive player that he set up and then moved up forward, and you can't do that. That was a good call. Nice rotation that time by West Virginia.
Litzley with a big-to-big opportunity for Marine.
Boy, Marine's open.
There's Harris.
Wow. Lovely. My goodness.
So Gray says, I'll launch.
I'm sure that's the time you want to launch. I think you want to pull it back and set up, execute, get the ball to Jay Crockett. There's no reason for that shot.
Particularly when you're two of your last 18 from three-point range. Jay Gray had a big one against Iowa State in his win here. He really struggled for three.
Good back cut.
State goes down hard.
Foul number 20.
West Virginia. Six-point lead for the Mountaineers, trying to get a third Big 12 win. Now this from Phillips 66.
Ty Nurse came into the game averaging just 1 point per game. He has 10 points here today, and Texas Tech running plays for him. This last scoring opportunity was supposed to be elevator doors. Look at Tolbert and Kravic. As you'll see Ty Nurse to the left of your screen, he comes through the middle of this elevator door, and those shoulders are supposed to come shut. They're supposed to pinch together. You see they don't come at all because the defensive player is nowhere near him, and they're not sure who to screen. But, boy, when you're running scoring opportunities for three-point shots for a guy who's coming into the game who's averaging just 1 point per game, now Ty Nurse has got it going here this afternoon.
Yeah, the season total, 18 points. Let me put this in perspective.
Season total.
Total. He had 10 points total since December the 19th. He has 10 points in this game. He has 28 points for the year. He had 266 points last year. He played almost every minute last year, and Tech goes to the zone.
This is a good adjustment. It was a nice play that time, a quick hitter by West Virginia. It was a diagonal screen, a staggered screen across the baseline for Caligula, and he was open and just couldn't get the ball to him.
Good recovery by Harris to save the day. 12 to shoot. West Virginia. Virginia, a little bit fertile against the zone until now. That's probably where they want to go. Free to shoot. Harris has got to pull it. Somebody's got to shoot it. Wow, great job by Tech in the zone. Great attack. That's what he did to Iowa State.
He hesitated at the elbow just a second and lifted his eyes up to the rim. Sometimes you don't even have to fake a shot. Just look at the rim, and it freezes the defensive player. Watch Josh Gray as he's coming up straight at you. Look, he stops, and he looks up. Yeah, he didn't. Right before he got to that point, he got to the elbow, and when he started slowing down, he lifted his chin up. Nice transition basket. Good defense.
Noreen gets hooked on the arm. Gocher got him. That's his second.
Well, Gocher's been good in this basketball game. I thought he was a real difference maker. Kind of changed the pace and the tempo of this game in the first half, and he's done a nice job off the bench for Chris Walker.
Jamal Williams Jr. comes back in, the junior from Brooklyn. Excellent. Offensive. Shoulder lowered. Down goes Tolbert. Second foul on Kalitsla.
This is just a tough call because that's exactly what you want Kalitsla to do. You want him to make contact, but then come back and drop step away from the contact. Don't keep going through it. You know, I apologize. I've been calling Gocher Gotcher in the first half. His name is pronounced Gocher, and I apologize for that.
Kid from the Metroplex actually got a hardship year last year. He had a foot injury after playing nine games, and now Tech turns it over.
And for the Mountaineers, number 24, Eric Murray. We're number 34.
Tech's gotten a little bit away from getting the ball to Jay Crockett and letting him attack, and they've kind of gone away from their leading scorer here in the second half.
Points.
Oh, what a save.
Crockett with the save. Tolbert, another block for West Virginia. Murray's got two. Kalitsla's got a couple. Quick shot by Aaron Brown. It's going to be a foul on Kalitsla. It's his third. Four team fouls now on Bob Huggins' team. Man, it's been work this year for Bob Huggins. You know, he said it after the Kansas loss. He goes, I don't lose very well, and I really don't lose very well when I wasn't expecting to lose.
Yeah, this just in.
Crockett. A little quick there with the trigger.
You know, I think he's just frustrated he hadn't gotten enough touches.
Harris hits a big three.
Boy, a foul on Jordan Tolbert, putting his body on Kalitsla and knocking him down. And the reverse of what just happened on the other end. And watch to the left of your screen. Oh, yeah, that's a good call. It's a good call. Boy, 4 or 5 point play opportunity for West Virginia.
So give three to Aaron Harris, his second three-pointer of the game. He's got 11. And give a third foul to Jordan Tolbert. Still 13-10 to go.
Ooh, that's a travel.
And a foul on Tech. This is going to go against Jamal Williams. That's his third. Just when Tech tries to get to the point to take the lead, West Virginia able to push him back.
This is the adjustment West Virginia needed to make in the second half. They needed to get to the free throw line, and you don't get to the free throw line settling for jump shots. You've got to attack the rim.
Staying with the roll, just his third point. He led the Atlantic 10 in assists when he was at the University of Dayton. And for Huggins, Bob Huggins this year, he was 9 of 9 free throwing in one game. He's a 78% shooter. He makes this, it's a 5-point trip.
teams with 14 turnovers.
Hands, State. That's what he did to Kansas on Monday night.
Oh, my goodness, he got up. There's going to be a delay of game warning, but that is a tough pass to make against West Virginia. When you try to reverse the ball back through the top from the wing, and it's a pass that's parallel to the free throw line, and it is a dangerous pass. And that is what Chris Walker said. No pick sixes in this game.
Well, a pick six for West Virginia, and they're back to a double-digit lead. 27. West Virginia leads by 10 because they're leading a stat they're not used to leading.
3-point shooting, West Virginia 8 for 16, shooting 50%. Texas Tech just 3 for 7. And let me tell you another statistic that's jumping out at you, and it is West Virginia has missed 18 field goal attempts in this game. They have 10 offensive rebounds. They are touching more than 50% of their missed shots, and, well, that is a good formula to win when you're on the road.
They have 8 threes made in the game. They normally get 5 per game. They are next to last in the league in shooting threes at 29%, but Tech then gets an easy bucket coming back from Kravich.
Excellent execution coming out of the timeout by Texas Tech. They ran that play through the first option, a diagonal, second option was a step out, and third option was a reverse. Good execution.
And a deep catch by Eric Murray, and Kravich has called for his third foul.
Watch Kravich. He sets the down screen. After he sets the down screen, then he dives to the basket. That was actually the third option, the third scoring option on that play. That is very good execution.
Credit to Chris Walker. Nice play.
America's play. A diagonal screen, a down screen, and dive to the basket. Call it America's play because everybody in America has got that play.
Got that play. Here's Eric Murray. At LaSalle in his 2 years for the Explorers, was second all-time in school history in blocked shots. You got to remember, that's the school that produced Lionel Simmons and others.
They're coming off a great game against Kansas. Eric Murray had 17 points, 7 rebounds.
He's had 3 double-doubles this year. It's just Bob Huggins wants it to be consistent for him.
Well, he has a beautiful release. Nice high extension, a beautiful follow-through.
He had 9 blocks in one game for LaSalle. Back to 10, West Virginia's biggest lead, a dozen. Tolbert follows his own miss and gets rewarded.
Ooh, Eric Murray's about to get a technical. Oh, man, I'm shocked. You know, their point of emphasis this year is decorum, and Eric Murray out there embarrassing the officials. Nice job of following his shot. Eric Murray plays great defense, and then look, he never moves. He's still straight up and down after the shot comes off, and this type of reaction has not been allowed all year long. I'm surprised that that's not a technical. Bob Huggins saying, look, you played good belly-up defense, but then bend your knees, turn around, and go get the rebound.
Yeah, he was screaming at him to rebound in the Kansas game as well, and Murray can rebound. He's had 10 or more boards 5 times this year for West Virginia. But no 3-point play as Tolbert misses the free throw.
What Bob Huggins is telling him is that you don't get 100% of the ones you don't go for.
And Kalitsa, a couple deep catches here for West Virginia now on back-to-back possessions. We'll come back. Kalitsa's got free throws. Now this from Phillips 66.
He said, look at your shoes from Under Armour, and look at your uniforms, and look at this beautiful arena. All of this is here because of men like Wizard White. And then he took it a step further, and he looked at Ty Nurse, and he said, Ty, in 20 years from now, if I'm blessed enough to be coach, I'm going to be standing on this court, and I'm going to say, hey, men, I'm going to introduce to you Ty Nurse. Ty was here in 2013, and he was a team. And what Ty Nurse helped build and establish and turn around is what you're playing for today. It was a really cool moment. I mean, it was a cool moment of a coach who understood the past and is trying to change a culture and build a program here in Lubbock. And boy, it was really fun that Chris Walker let us be a part of that and listen in and stand out there on the court and listen to Mr. White talk.
I love it when coaches do that, Reed, because sometimes players can get so self-absorbed.
I mean, you're talking about traveling by cars.
Yeah, well, they lose track of what they're about and where they fit in history.
Well, Chris says, hey, we're traveling by charter planes. These guys loaded into cars, drove to Austin, and played a back-to-back, got in their cars, and drove back. I mean, how's that for perspective?
What's Austin, like 7 hours from here?
It is a haul.
But West Virginia's the same way. Yep. Bob Huggins, who played at West Virginia, can sit there and talk. This was the school of Jerry West, Hot Rod Hundley, Rod Thorne. And in recent years, you get, you know, guys like Kevin Jones.
But coaches make a mistake, and you said it, not enough people do it. Coaches make a mistake by not incorporating that in kids. And so often we say kids don't appreciate the pass, and but you see guys like Wizard White sitting in the stands at 92 years old. You know, he left college and went to World War II, was in the Navy, came back in Lubbock, was in a construction business. And, boy, it's part of who Jay Crockett is and what Jay Crockett's building on. And I just thought that was a really cool moment.
Jay Crockett tries for a three-point play as both teams now finding foul issues. And just so there's no confusion, there was a Wizard White that was a football player at Colorado who became a Supreme Court Justice. This is another Wizard White. This is the tech version of Wizard White. Crockett, Reed, that's his first points of the second half. We've played nearly 9 minutes.
He has only attempted one field goal. He took that shot, a quick shot at the top of the key. And, boy, coming out of this timeout, it's a situation where Chris Walker's got to say, we have got to go to Jay Crockett. Good defense.
Contact and a foul on Daylon Robinson. Double bonus now for West Virginia.
Daylon Robinson was in perfect position and then fell the wrong way. The guy's coming at him, and if he'd have fallen down the baseline, he might have gotten a charge. Instead, he fell up the lane, and it's hard to get a charge call when you fall the opposite direction of where you're hit.
And so Aaron Harris goes to the line, the talented freshman from Indianapolis. 81% shooter. He's the Mountaineers in scoring this afternoon with a dozen. I like his game, man, Aaron Harris, as Robinson sets.
West Virginia doing a much better job getting to the free throw line here in the second half.
Before the Kansas game, he was 11 of 22 from three, was Harris. Kansas shut him down. He had no field goals against them, but they'll do that to anybody, leading the nation in field goal percentage defense. Back to eight. West Virginia always answers.
Oh, my.
Colbert right around Eric Murray.
Great job of Jordan Tolbert of keeping his eye on that ball. And Jay Crockett threw up a shot. It ended up just being a pass. But look at the nice job of Jordan Tolbert. Went up there, well, got away with a little bit of an elbow.
You know what's interesting about West Virginia? I think teams get surprised with them, either in early offense or in the regular offense, when they reverse at the top. That is normally allowed by teams.
Yep.
West Virginia disallows it. There's a couple of times that a tech's been surprised. I'm just going to pass it to the top. Ooh, there's a big out there.
So much of your offense is predicated on the ability to swing the ball from side to side. West Virginia makes a commitment that once you put it on a side, keep it on that side.
Three on Murray now for West Virginia. A bunch of guys with three fouls in this game both ways.
You don't accidentally win 719 basketball games.
Bob Huggins wins today. He will pass Don Haskins, the famous Bear of Glory Road fame in Texas Western, on the all-time wins list.
Well, the third winningest active coach behind Coach Krzyzewski and Boeheim. He is closing in on the 18th winning this position. And six wins, he'll pass Ray Meyer on that list.
Speaking of Don Haskins, I bet you got Wizard played him. They were old rivals, Texas Western, Texas Tech.
Oh, my goodness. Wow. Jay Nurse came up and set a back screen on Caligula. Caligula just crushed him. Originally, they pointed the other way like it was an offensive foul, but they corrected that. Watch coming up the left of your screen, this diagonal screen. He hits him, and, boy, Caligula just flattens him.
Well, this is an issue now because that is four fouls on Dennis Caligula of West Virginia.
Listen, whoever's guarding Ty Nurse has got to tell Caligula that diagonal. First of all, he shouldn't have to tell him because Tech's run that play about 15 times today. And you should know that when you're on the opposite side elbow, you're getting a back screen. But someone needs to communicate it so when you turn around with those big shoulders, you don't flatten some little guard.
Either that or put another bag of ice in the cold tub because you're going to feel it. Nurse has a 1-1. Ty Nurse is back. That's 5 of 5. Again, he was 90%. Last year at the foul line. Today, His five attempts are the first he has had all season, and we're on February 2nd, unless I've lost track of my days. Here's Tech right back in the game. 4 points, but West Virginia's answered all afternoon as Chris Walker's team keeps trying to overtake the Mountaineers.
Well, West Virginia does not need a jump shot on this possession. They need to get that ball to the paint and attack the rim.
And no Kalichi. Excellent crossover. Sweet move by Juwan Staten.
Staten had a jump shot coming off of this elbow screen, turned it down, which I think was a great. Right there, he had a jump shot. Instead of settling, he backed up and attacked the rim. And I think that is almost flawless execution by Juwan Staten.
Went behind the back to set it up, and then that deep low cross. And Staten, one of two, gets two here. Double bonus. Rest of the way for West Virginia.
Let me say something that's silly. Shooting 78% from the free throw line only helps you if you get to the free throw line. You got to get to the line, and that's what West Virginia's doing. The last two games as a team, they've shot 80%. And, well, when they attack the rim in this position, it's sure going to help them finish off a game on the road.
And again, the answer. Back to six, still loads of time. The start of a big Saturday in the Big 12. Nurse travel.
He just got himself in trouble. That was a good call. Good defense by Noreen.
Offensive foul, West Virginia. Dominic Rutledge called for the foul.
Dominic Rutledge. How about the grab?
Well, Huggins, yeah, he is furious with that call.
He's had better days, he's had better years, but he'd love to win on the road here. He was able to win at Texas. He's been close. He was close to beating K-State at home. Gave Kansas all they wanted on Big Monday.
Ooh, that went off Tolbert's leg. You can't be the last one to touch it in the front court and the first one in the back court. The ball was poked loose, but I think that went off of his thigh. Crockett, I mean. Oh, Tech just can't reverse the ball. They can't run their set. Excellent defense. Excellent defense.
Ray just decides to pull. No other options.
West Virginia just pounding the rim. I mean, they are attacking that rim every possession. Might be a good opportunity to go to a 2-3 zone and see if they can knock down some jump shots if you're Texas Tech.
Jordan Tolbert's got his fourth foul.
Gary Brown shooting two.
And we're headed to a casualty list because there are several guys that are on the edge of the diving board here, close to being disqualified both ways. Gary Brown has not scored in the second half.
And for the Red Raiders, number two,
83% from the free throw line for the season for Gary Brown. Third in the Big 12, trailing only two Kansas players, Ben McLemore and Travis Relaford. A lot of people in foul trouble right now.
We've got the menu for you coming up. Both coaches already know it. West Virginia's done a great job at the line here in the last several minutes. And they push Tech back again by eight.
Now, only five free throw attempts in the first half, 12 in the second half for West Virginia.
Gravich goes after Noreen. And that is the fourth foul on Noreen. So Kalichla four, Noreen four. Murray three, the bigs of West Virginia trying to defend without fouling, and that's been Tech's issue. They can't defend West Virginia without fouling.
You know, you hate for a game to come down to free throw attempts. Well, that's exactly what we anticipated in this game. It's going to be turnovers and free throw attempts. Who gets the most attempts at the free throw line, and do you knock them down? Right now, Texas Tech, 14 for 17, shooting 82%, and West Virginia, 13 for 18.
What we did not expect was West Virginia hitting eight threes, 50% from three. They're 29% for the year, back to six.
But, you know, they had eight at halftime.
Ooh. Murray, tough shot, being creative. He's got double figures with 10.
Tell you something, that was a consistent no call. Murray used his right elbow, very similar to what we saw Jordan Tolbert on the other end use his left elbow. Good, consistent officiating.
Williams wanted to reverse the ball and couldn't. Then he had trouble staying on the same side. Man, West Virginia does a great job of that. They're going to keep you on one half of the floor if they can. Gray, slice.
Beautiful. Boy, that was beautiful.
Creating offense with defense. And Gray's got a
turnover, 17 for West Virginia, 16 for Texas Tech. I'm telling you, we're going to finish this game, and both teams are going to have 20 turnovers.
Murray, offensive foul with the elbow. He's got four. Still 6:51 to go. Is Crockett the best sixth man in the country among the BCS Power Six leagues? We'll give you the data when we come back. West Virginia leading 59-53. 12 divided by 2 is 6. That's its sixth man. The Big 12 may have a market on the best six men in the Power 6 Conference.
Three of the top five, certainly. Nobody better than Jay Crockett rebounding and scoring. Tyrus McGee at Iowa State and Phil Forte. And Jay Crockett, appropriately, is our Motel sixth man of the game. 10 points, 3 rebounds, 3 steals. And all of that in with foul trouble in just 17 minutes of action.
And Forte got to be the throw-in for Marcus Smart on that Flower Mound Marcus team. More than a throw-in. Heck of a play.
That would be a misperception.
Devontae Gardner, also Marquette, was on that list. One of the strongest sixth man of the Big East.
Ooh, nice hesitation.
Hannes has been yet to get going from three. Gray, teardrop.
Josh Gray!
4-point game. Here's Tech again, and yet West Virginia has to answer again, but West Virginia saddled with foul problems among its bigs.
It just did not have his balance that time. Eric Murray went up and did not have his base underneath him.
Hannes and walks with it. A double dribble, should say. Dusty Hannes yet to score in this game. They were trying to get him a three. He's third in the conference in three-point shooting percentage. Told you, big day in the league. Also a big week coming up. And it's a big turnover. These possessions become valuable now.
Tech in a 2-3 zone. No, they're not. They're in a man. Turnovers, what a huge story in this game.
Harris setting it up for him. Splash home again. Aaron Harris has 16 points.
Huge, huge basket for West Virginia. Tech was giving him a cushion, daring him to knock down a shot, and Aaron Harris accepted that challenge.
3 second half threes. Reed for Aaron Harris. 13 second half points. This has been the trend the whole half. Tech makes a run, gets within four. West Virginia gets back up. And now they're lead by 7 with possession.
Another turnover. 17 for Texas Tech, 18 for West Virginia.
Tech has never led in this game. A three hit by Gary Brown. And all of a sudden, West Virginia's turned into Iowa State. That is 9 made threes or 10 made threes for the Mountaineers. They only get five per game on the average.
Excellent decision by State to pull that ball out.
How about West Virginia, Reed? 10 of 18, 55% from three. It's an easier game when you hit three.
Yeah, it is. You know, that's why a 2-3 zone wouldn't have worked. You know, I keep saying, why don't you try it, why don't you try it? Chris Walker will look over at me and say, because they've knocked down 10 three-pointers, then you extend out, you create driving lanes, and end up with an easy basket.
And West Virginia has tied its biggest lead of the game at 12.
I think this is the West Virginia basketball team, the way they've executed and played here in the second half that, quite frankly, we expected to see all season long.
30-second timeout, Texas Tech.
For a three-pointer, could have got it to one. But this is the big news of the day. 29% for the Mountaineers from three, not today. They look like Jerry Westing from deep.
And that's what's so difficult about game planning. You know, you come in, you look at statistically, and you say, you know, you're going to have to make them beat us by threes, and then they do.
Oh, don't push him out. Watch him.
I really think when Texas Tech goes back and looks at this game film, they're going to be frustrated with how few touches in the second half Jay Crockett got. Another turnover. Wow.
Said 20. That's where they're at. State and finishes. And West Virginia threatening to blow it open here in West Texas. And how quickly one turnover, that double dribble over near Chris Walker. It's like the water rolling into the spillway.
And there's a timeout on the floor.
The Mountaineers have hit defense today, and they've hit threes. This is the team Bob Huggins thought he would have. Well, he just swaps everything away now. Were they keeping it when Will Chamberlain played there?
No, they were not.
He'd have like 7,000 of them, but here, West Virginia. Has blocked four shots. Mostly they've made 10 three-pointers, and this is our Geico player of the game. Is Aaron Harris in this game, 16 points, three threes, 13 of his 16 have been in the second half.
Yeah, that's the point. The 16 points is nice, but it's when those points have come and where they have come on the floor, and especially when they have come with the time left on the clock. A big game for Aaron Harris.
Becomes key for West Virginia as they try to move forward this season and the rest of the year. This has got to give the Mountaineers some confidence. A 1,500-mile one-way trip. They got in here late last night after 10 o'clock and come out here and hit 10 threes. And they're going to travel 1.25 trips around the equator this year before the season's over.
That's staggering. Every time you say that, I think, golly, that's a lot of travel.
The space station travels that much. Ben Harris's game, and he's going to the line.
A perfect possession. I mean, they pulled the ball out. They ran the shot clock down below 15, attacked the basket, end up on the free throw line with a kid that shoots 81%.
At the line, Aaron Harris, 2-2.
Throw good, and Harris is closing in on a career high. Log on to Big12Sports.com/CTB and check out the Big 12 Network announcer blogs covering the baseline. This week, Dave Armstrong discusses a common theme in the Big 12 this season. It's must read. We got to get people continuing education credit for reading. Pretty good stuff. This one's getting away from Tech.
Now 20 for the Red Raiders.
Really crushed them in their loss at Austin after they tried to build something after their win here against Iowa State. Well, West Virginia's defense, their pressure defense, has been good today. Rutledge.
Dominic Rutledge.
The junior college ball of Western Texas. Before coming into Huggins Pro gets a three, he's got 13.
First field goal of the second half. He had a free throw.
Two free throws and a three.
That's not enough that. You know, your leading scorer, your best player, you've got to get him the ball. You've got to get him the ball in scoring opportunities, and he's got to realize that he's got a burden on his shoulders, and he's got to look to be more assertive on the offensive end.
I wonder what this does for West Virginia now. This gives them a shot at confidence. They're trying to get on the roll. Again, this is a team that's been in nine straight postseasons for five straight NCAAs and the Final Four in 2010. And coming up next, Oklahoma State is on the road. We mentioned Marcus Smart. He's at Allen Fieldhouse today, a battle of freshmen, McLemore and Smart.
Battle of freshmen and maybe two leading candidates for player of the year in the Big 12.
It's happened twice. Beasley did it, so did Kevin Durant. They were players of the year and freshman of the year in the same season.
They were pretty good.
Not too bad, one of those two might be making it a third.
You look at the standings, Mitch, and there's clearly a line of delineation from Iowa State down to Texas Tech. Well, for West Virginia, you win this game, you go to 3-5. If you can get on a roll, get momentum, I really feel like 60% of the league's going to end up in the NCAA tournament. This may be exactly the kind of win because of the way they've played on the road that could really get West Virginia going.
Well, let's just go through the next several games. Texas at home at home at West Virginia.
They will be favored.
Okay, let's go right down the line. I'll have them next Saturday at TCU. So the Texas game's at Morgantown. No. Then they play TCU on the road.
They'll be favored in that game.
At Baylor right after that. Curious how Huggs will handle the travel. He's got a Saturday, then a midweek game at TCU at Baylor.
So you're 3-5. You go get three. You go into Baylor at 6-5.
And you've got Texas Tech at home. They get this game going back on the 16th of February. Then you're at K-State, Oklahoma State at home, Baylor home. There is a chance for the Mountaineers with four games coming up in Morgantown to make a run.
Well, and that's not saying they're going to win those games. I'm just saying if you're Bob Huggins, what do you take from this? Well, you go back in the locker room, you say this was a good win, guys. We played the way we needed to. Now let's keep it going.
77-61, and Bob Huggins has now passed legendary the Bear, Don Haskins, for 18th all-time on the wins list. West Virginia by 16 on the road.